Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm gonna do the first impressions on the e.l.f. blending sponge. I just got this today and I have not dampened it yet, so I'm gonna dampen it right now. Oh, I just basically went with water. It feels so weird. And squeeze out all the water to where it's dampened and it feels soft on the skin. So just in case if this doesn't blend out as well, I obviously am trying to chew my foundation brush. So let's get started. So obviously first I'm going to prime my face with the Photo Focus face primer. Again. So, I obviously didn't get any on my nose. Sorry if I'm kind of whispering. I did not mean to do that. But right now, I'm just putting it into the skin. I just got it all in my hair. Obviously, don't forget to get your ears, your neck, all up in your head. Oh, and if you're wondering, why am I sitting up so different? I am at my grandma's house right now. Just to, stay the night. And if you hear, like, any little running around and I have to look down occasionally, I have my mom's dog, Harley, in here. So now I'm gonna go in with the Photo Focus Wet n Wild Foundation Classic Beige, and I found my dupe shade, which is a little bit lighter, but I think it will match my skin perfectly, is Buff Beige. I've heard people say this is called Buff Bisque. I don't know why they call it that. It's weird. And I just realized that I'm gonna have a whole lot of fun taking this makeup off tonight. Because I forgot to bring any makeup wipes, because I know I have to start getting used to me having to do my makeup and having my makeup done. Because later in the year, I think by Thanksgiving or Christmas, my sister will be up here, and I may or may not be moving. So right now I'm gonna go in with the beauty blender. This is my very first actual beauty blender. Like, I had the orange one, but it didn't work out for my skin very well because it was a slanted one and I don't like slanted ones. Okay. And I have my handheld there. This is actually soaking up my foundation. Yeah, okay, I'm gonna try swiping. That helps. Yes. It's dropping up. Way too much of my product. As you see right here, it is blotchy. That's probably not enough on this.
Okay, I'm gonna try it again for the top for concealer.
So
I'm gonna go in and try to chew. True.
Is up with my skin today, but it's not wanting to take any foundation. What is that? This one part does not look bad. So now I'm gonna go through and try to make it look flawless. That actually helped a lot. So now, I think for the first time, I might actually use the Goop contour. I'm gonna try it. That is so cool. I'm gonna go in concealer. And with a top end of the baby blender. It's not wanting to blend. Thank you. You can see it's blending them out perfectly. I'm kind of trying to swipe a little bit
as I'm dabbing.
And then I'm gonna take with this one side.
I think I'm gonna use a brush for it, yeah. It is burning up my under eyes. So,
I'm okay with it. It's not really helping me. Reasons why I like using a brush. So, first impressions of it, it kind of works and kind of not works. So, I'm going to go in now. My large stipple brush by Wind Wand. And go in with my contour shade. I try to blend it. Well, as far as I know, I don't like cream contour. I just need to try out a better one. So now again, I'm gonna go back in with this mouse brush. I'm gonna fix it. I'm gonna go in with the Precision Foundation brush. I'm gonna go down into this banana shade right here on the caramel toffee bun. And I'm just going to very quickly set my under eyes and wherever else I highlighted with the concealer. I need to buy a new one. A lot. So I'm just putting this where it's concealed. So it doesn't crease up. And I have this stuff baking. Foundation looks a little more orange on me in person, but not on the camera. You can't tell on the camera. It looks a little bit cakey because of the foundation, because of the beauty blender. So I'm gonna go back in with the beauty blender really quick on my handy dandy handheld mirror that I got in Target for $1. going very quickly. I'm all over. So today, I'll be going for a little bit of a batch opening look. Since I forgot one of my eyeshadow palettes that I was going to bring, I only brought my two eyeshadow sheets because I just grabbed my box that had all my makeup in it. And I swore I put my foundation in my eyeshadows in there. Reclaimed it. And also, this is my first impression on the crease brush. I'm gonna try out this one. So I'm gonna very quickly set the face real quick with the little bonus. Kumar shade by The Balm Cosmetics. And I guess now because the lighting's way better, you can tell. Yeah, I'm gonna hit pan very soon. So right now I'm gonna go in with this crease brush by Winwell that I just got at Dollar Tree. $1. And I'm gonna go in here. Now if you use white brushes, you can well specifically tell. I'm gonna put this in my crease. Obviously, I'm not gonna do circular motions on the lid. So here again, I dip. Shake off any excess, and I'm just gonna swirl it into my. So now I'm going to go in with, I think my Smashbox X-rated, better than my X-rated mascara by Smashbox. So, as I was saying earlier, I might be moving in with my sister and in Fort Worth, and so I went ahead and looked for all my options over. Job-wise. And knowing me, I've always wanted to work in a makeup store. I don't know why. I always wanted to work in a makeup store. So, as time comes for me to move up there, I'm going to fill out applications for places like Sephora, Ulta, Best Buy, and also Lowe's, which is a place that my sister works. She's asleep on my foot. So now I'm gonna go in with the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. Real quick. Texture coating. Oh. So now, and I'm going to very quickly to the face. Tastes good. So next is highlighter and lips. I'm actually going to be putting on my celebrity skin. Jennifer Cosmetics Skin Frost and Peach Goddess Shampoo. Gorgeous. And yes, if you sort of can't tell, the J's are lifted on it. So now I'm gonna go in with my taper. Just gonna do very quick. And bam. Okay, let's get a full side of the brush. Damn it. I'm just gonna dust it on me. Look, even if because I dusted it on me. Of course, this has a mirror on it, so please, the mirror. Here we go. I'm not gonna like a cupid's bow. And down the bridge of my nose. To blending. So I'm gonna go in with the Beauty Blender, kinda to blend down just a little. Okay. Got a little highlight. So now I'm gonna go in with my lip ammunition in shade Celebrity Skin. I really wish this thing would focus on it. Oh, beautiful. It smells like orange creamsicles. So I can get a bit of my hand again. There's the face. I'm gonna close this. Time for me to reset it. And yes, I just now realized that there's a little black. I'm going to cut my hair down. Show you what it looks like. So here it is, the final look and first impressions of the e.l.f. blending sponge. Now, since this is my first time using the blending sponge, I really don't like it. I mean, I like it, it can settle my highlight. It doesn't look like it's because we have lights right here. And they immediately deep down, like, even if I have no foundation on and no highlight, you even saw on my phone that my nose was glowing already. And it looks like there's highlighter on my mascara, on my makeup right here. Which I don't. So, again, here's the final look. And first impressions of the blending sponge. Now, as you saw, it implied my foundation like super blotchy, and I really did not like that. So here is my very first impressions. My very first impressions of the e.l.f. blending sponge. Now, I really wanted to buy the primer mist. I really want to try the primer mist. I really do. Because I want to see, because I heard from some beauty bloggers that the e.l.f. primer mist is a dupe for the Morphe set prime and set spray. I want the Morphe one too, because it's like $14 for it. And for the e.l.f. one is only $8. So I really wanted to do those. I'm sorry, I just keep messing with my hair. So here it is. Final look and first impressions. Okay, sorry, I have to move y'all. Of the e.l.f. blending sponge. So remember, leave a like and subscribe. And again, if you want to be a shout out, all you had to do is comment on my last video, and the first couple of people who I see will be a shout out. And please don't forget to subscribe. So I love you all and have a good day.